novice bracket.
Yep.
Now, we got the new four characters, and right here, yeah, as you can see on our screen, that we have one of them, like in to start us off with in winners round two or winners quarterfinals. How do you think this matchup is going to play out?
I feel like with the new bomb changes, Molo still can kind of throw around Finisher for just basically threatening the Raster. Basically, Finisher could just kill really early.
However,
I don't really know how the matchup would actually work out, though, because I don't really think... What do you think about the matchup? Because I have no clue.
So far, like, I think in particular, like, Raster's presence in the air, like, is now, like, slightly saved. Because, like, before, there was, like, no really safe landing so to refresh your jumps, but you don't really need it as Raster. But it's also a nice thing to have. Because, like, now Raster can, like, slightly, like regain their bearings and, like, camp them out if need be. Because, like you said, finishing bomb, like, all the bombs really got nerfed aside from Flashbang.
Yeah. So Flashbang, when it's being used in context of camping, definitely got nerfed.
Yeah, but now Molo has great boxing tools, so I don't see why you need have any kind of the need to camp.
Yeah.
But anyways, let's get into it. Alright, starting off with the slipstream.
Yep.
And right now, Aegir... trying to just go for the throw immediately.
Mixing the down smash, right ledge.
Oh yeah, but
right.
Like...
Molo got back up to see.
But as we can see, like, both these characters have amazing recovery tools. We were talking about earlier, like, now Bradshaw or Aegir, like, can now, like, just go in, and, like, if they need be, they can just stay back.
You know, I never even thought about it. How light is Molo?
I don't know.
Clap, I can tell that forward clap, if I mean tip rain, almost killed him. Like a 55 or something.
Yo, and right now, like, as of right now, so far, Aegir is in control. And thank you, Sam,
because of the raid. I feel like a lot of times the Drank, they're getting hit by their own bombs. Like, it happened like 3 times in pretty sure I saw already. Maybe twice, holy.
Oh yeah, that's one thing to be aware of. Like, Molo can kill himself with his own bomb, so like, that is like one thing.
Yeah, if you notice Molo's just recovering and has a bomb in their hand, you could just kind of go up to them without even like trying to pressure them and make them get hit with their own bomb.
But this could also double as like offense, because like right now, well, this is not really a good example of it, but like, oh hey,
yeah,
and Edrain takes the lead.
All right.
Over Aegir. But
and
as
I feel
saying,
like something he could have done at ledge is definitely just put Finisher at ledge. That's a pretty good tool.
Not even just put it at ledge, just like pressure, like you just have the bomb on him and like use the bat. So like it's already
Finisher
starting
is
to explode.
Just pressuring Aegir, doing nice damage so far.
Oh yeah, most definitely.
They have the lead. It's kind of just sitting there. Tried to slipstream, but it got hit out by a bomb on the floor.
Yeah, I don't know.
What about now?
No, nothing. But anyways, like, yeah, you were saying...
Oh, somebody said there's an echo in your mic.
Yeah, no, I
chat. Oh, that's what we're talking about.
Yep. Okay, but anyways, right now...
Something I forgot, thought was a bit weird was, apparently if the Molo has a bomb on the floor, it interrupted the slipstream. So
oh no, oh wow, Aegir almost had the...
he almost had him.
Oof,
oh,
almost
fair.
Sending him to hell.
This
but
is
Aegir,
the forward smash. Can Aegir recover from this?
He can, because F-Drink decided to save him. He was dead.
And forward clap off the down tilt.
And
in return,
he gets double kicked in the face.
I don't agree with that up special right there. I don't really know.
Agree or not, this is the situation we're in right now. And right now, Aegir is in the driver's seat right as of right now.
Alright. Kind of just let him get back to safe breather.
If I was Aegir, like, he doesn't really have to approach.
Oh, like, down?
He's doing that to down the smash. Letter. What?
Oh!
See what I mean?
He's at the funny number. To. He can't lose. Oh, he's no longer at the funny number.
F-Drank trying to find an opening, but Aegir, unlike F-Drank, is just blowing it down doors.
Yeah. They got the dare, but nothing off of it. Parry. Drop smash.
This is a dangerous spot for both players.
Oh, fair. Just rising, trying to get that fair at ledge.
Oh, and parry so the up air. This could be anybody's game. And
there's a clap.
Good shit. So, knowing what we know now, like, that was interesting.
Yeah.
Where F-Drank dropped the ball was when he went for dare, like off the ledge. Because I most certainly believe Aegir was dead.
Yeah.
And that's where it started going downhill.
I feel like F-Drank thought Aegir could have recovered and wanted to hit him anyways, but it was just way too trigger happy there.
One thing I like to say is sometimes less is more. And that is one instance of where less was most definitely more. Because that cost him the stock. And that's when it started going downhill. But right now, we transition to game two. And we are in Tower of Heaven.
Yep.
And we're standing there. F-Drank going for the bomb immediately. And Aegir going for the slipstream immediately.
They're going for the pairs. Of misses it.
Alright. Trying to like. Now, if I was F-Drank, I would imagine.
Do you think F-Drank actually chose the stage? Particular.
You see, you saw that. You saw him using Upstrong, right?
Yeah.
Upstrong hits.
Does Upstrong cover the whole platform?
It covers like basic. Options? Yeah, it basically covers like a lot of it. Like enough.
Mola up smash is pretty. It's pretty strong.
But as you said, with the new balance patches, there was like slight nerfs, and Mola. Yeah,
and
Upstrong
did get really nerfed.
Ooh, interesting choice for that. I would have gone for down smash if my personal opinion.
Yeah,
and, like
definitely.
Try to go for nair. But
or like dare up smash.
So far, I can't really talk because it's the heat of the moment, and right now in this very moment he's in the lead. But whew, that almost killed him. Right now.
Oh, can Iger kill off this?
No. Now, right now, I think Iger might—he needs this kill right now, and there's the down smash because like Malo's hitting that percent, where like it's gonna be very hard to combo, and Commodore's curse.
The forward clap just does it.
Oh, let's go! And right now,
got the down smash.
Double down smash. Let's go. Right now, F-Drank has got to be thinking, I got to either, like, slow it down to my pace, or, like, he basically has to change the tempo
right now. I feel like in neutral, they can definitely go even, but when Iger just gets an advantage, he's pushing it much more than... Oh,
amazing!
That was wrong.
Spectacular, spectacular ending to that, but, like, if this was anybody else, I would say this is not a worry, because, like, he has the percent lead, but Raster is extremely light.
Yeah.
And like, literally F-Drank can yank the rug out of Aegir.
Just do the finisher and it'll... The finisher got there pretty hard too, right?
No, I don't think finisher would kill, like, as of right now.
Unless, yeah,
like,
definitely not.
Aegir has like immensely bad DI, but I don't believe so.
Oh, hit by their own bomb. I think they tried the dash attack.
Ooh, and the forward cap. Cinching in the opening. Good stuff. What do you think F-Drank has to do to turn this around?
Honestly, I feel like F-Drank has to really slow it down and just focus on his disadvantage against Iger. Because Iger's doing much more in his advantage compared to F-Drank.
Okay, and what stage choice do you think, like, with knowing what we know now, like, what like Tower of Heaven clearly didn't work with the double plats. Which stage do you think he would be considering?
With Mallo, I think probably. I'm honestly not very sure because I didn't really know anything about what Mallo likes in stages. I'm not really that.
Personally, I would have probably taken it to Merchant Port because, like, just exploit it's the small stage in the game with, like, two plats right there and then, like, up air being immensely strong, which I haven't seen much of.
Up air is definitely a really great kill move if you can get it.
But this could also come in return for Aegir. He can, like, also exploit that.
Yeah,
too.
He can. Yeah, definitely.
But we will find out because we are not going to Merchant Port. We are going to Spirit Tree.
Yeah. I'm gonna see some nice combos here. Alright, Aegir already getting a bit of fares and the down smash.
Alright. So far, like, has been a really good run. Good going for F2.
They're almost even now. Oh, F2. Okay.
Nah, man.
Oh,
even or not, that doesn't look pretty even to me. Because right now, stealing the stock. F-Drink trying to go for the F-Tilt on bomb. I think at that angle, it would have hit. But... oh, so far. Aegir, now, I think he has him on lock. And F-Drink doesn't...
oh, he didn't notice. F-Drink just kind of went for the S-Smash after the parry. Didn't realize it was a jab.
Trying to
have
them,
basically the same percent right now. Yeah.
Yeah, same percent, but like right now, like same percent, different stock though.
Yeah.
What? Right now, like
missed it.
But I like to say
Aegir's off stage now. Can F though?
No, you can't get anything off it. So far, Aegir is still in the driver's seat. But like I was saying, like this in this game, like momentum is like what matters the most. Like
momentum
right
is
now,
key.
Right now, Aegir has like a majority of it. So like stock count almost doesn't matter.
I thought there was gonna be a down smash. Yeah, I thought there was gonna be a down smash.
I personally think that was a good choice.
Yeah.
Trying to get rid
of the DI. Just didn't go far enough to make it connect.
Oh no.
In there?
Purple killings. Because I was about to say if F-Drink was like able to keep that stock in particular. Oh wow! Hey,
oh, and up air. There it is.
Because like I was about to say he needed to keep that stock because like he was out of range for kills.
All of Molo's bombs give no parry stun.
Oh.
So kind of parrying them just makes it easier to approach Mallo.
No. Oh yeah, they don't get... I don't think so either, yeah.
Yeah, no, not even finisher.
So yeah, no, like... man.
F-Drink
Trying to go for the honk. Needs to find a way out and, like, just not get hit by meaningful hits.
Just getting
like,
juggled by so many hits.
Like, this is fine, just as long as none of them are, like, key hits.
Parry there.
Oh, and speaking of key hits, that was, like, the one...
yeah.
The one not needed. Oh, shit, I did not have the, I didn't have the scoreboard. Whoops. Hey, Aegir taking a 3-0. Yeah, my bad.
We're not gonna
email
your channel.
Oh yeah, let's go. Anyways, we're gonna move on to the other side of winners.
Yep.
Kyle.
Yeah.
Let's Sad to see him get smacked. But yeah, no, unfortunate indeed.
What?
How do you spell your name? Yeah, no, I'm just gonna... Should have been doing this while the set was going on, I'll be honest. Anyways,
yeah.
What did you think of that match?
I thought it was really great. The first game, it definitely seemed much more even than the last. I feel like Iger really just kind of played much more at his pace, which was overwhelming. Rank, and also started really parrying the bombs. I noticed that a lot more. Seen a lot more of his parry game.
Sorry, this is very scuffed. This was very last minute. I'm gonna be completely honest with you guys.
Bro, the stream was very last minute. I was the one who was gonna stream it, but then Discord just didn't want to cooperate with audio.
Okay. Kyle. Maple.
We got a maple?
Yeah, we got a maple.